I'm Karen Burnside.
My name is Carter Burnside, and we're married. We're married 28 years.
I came up to visit my senior year in high school, and I really liked the campus, and it just seemed like the right fit, and that's why I came to Morningside.
I started out school at University of South Dakota at Vermilion, and I started there in fall of 1978. And I ended up in Morningside because I had to leave USD because of social and academic issues. I ended up at Morningside. It was kind of a transitional phase in my life.
Carter and I first met in the, let's see, it's August before my senior year at Morningside, and we were down by Transit Avenue, and he had just come out of his dad's office, and he was all dressed up in his little Amoco uniform, getting ready to go to work, and one of them thought he was cute, and so I was hoping that once school started, we would maybe date.
If my memory corrects me, it was either at the Sugar Bowl, or we met at the 80 Pie House in the basement. Okay, that's both wrong, isn't it? Okay, Karen, I'm sorry. What was our first date?
Carter and I, our first date was the Diamond Ball of 1980.
That's right.
It was my sorority dance. I asked Carter to go to the dance. After we went to Diamond Ball, Carter met my best friend Darla, and he really liked Darla, so he wanted to ask Darla out, but Darla turned him down and said no, she wouldn't go out with him because she knew I liked him.
We started dating after that, probably a couple weeks. We had a date, I remember a date down in the basement. Remember at the sorority house?
We had a
special evening.
We had a fire in
yeah.
The fireplace.
I remember those first dates.
It was kind of planned. We went and picked out the ring together. And then he came over and gave me the ring, I think on a Friday night, before he went deer hunting. He had to go home and get a good night's sleep so he could go deer hunting the next day. So then I went out and met all my friends to show him my ring and show him that I was engaged.
And if I remember right, that was in December of, was it December of 81 or December of 82?
We got engaged in December of 1982.
Okay. I realized that Karen was the person for me, and I realized that you know, she had a lot of great qualities that I thought I needed to be part of for the rest of my life.
I just knew because he just felt like he was the right one. And I loved his personality. He was pretty much opposite of me. And I guess they say opposites attract.
We got married on September 24th, 1983 in Newton, Iowa at the Methodist Church in Newton.
That stands out the most from my wedding day was getting ready to walk down the aisle and seeing Carter down there.
Also the friends gathering, all the people that I hadn't seen for a long time were together on that special day.
We had a wedding, and then we had the church reception, and then after that we had another reception at a hotel where people came over. We did not have a wedding dance, but 2 weeks later in Sioux City we had a big reception for everyone in Sioux City that didn't make it to the wedding in Newton, and we had a dance there. I do not remember the very first song that they played when we went out there together to
dance. Do not remember that.
We didn't really have much of a honeymoon right away because Carter was still in school. In December, we took a weekend and we went to Omaha for about 2 days. That was our honeymoon. Carter is a very caring person. He works hard for his family, and he's a great father and husband, and he just is a fun guy to be around. He makes life fun.
You know, I would describe Karen as a person that is a very caring person, you know, has love of life, loves her children. She's a great mother, a great wife. She's always has a caring heart.
What I admire most about Carter is just his, the way he gets along with everybody, all the people that he meets, and he seems to have a great relationship with all his co-workers and people at the church and all his family members.
With Karen, I think is that she's able to be in a very much a helping mode with everybody around her, whether it's her kids, whether it's her co-workers, whether it's at church, whether it's myself.
First years of marriage was an adjustment period. I think it always is. We left the city and we moved to Fremont, Nebraska, and we didn't know anyone there. Of course, Carter, he learns to know people very quickly, and I'm not as outgoing as him. Communication is one of the big keys to a successful marriage, and also being on the same page, especially when you have children, and discussing things. I always knew that I wanted to have children. We were both only children, and so we had decided and talked before we got married that we wanted to at least have a couple children. I found I was going to be a parent for the first time because I wasn't feeling well, so I got a home pregnancy test and realized I was pregnant.
My feelings were joy, excitement, a new venture. You know, this is going to be neat, having kids. Here we go. We have three children.
Cassie, I saw a sign on the highway one day that said Casey. The next child, Charisse, we named her after one of our college friends. Her name was Charisse, and we thought that was a very pretty name. We named our son Jake after Carter's grandfather.
Yeah. I think we had a little disagreement on Charisse. All three of our children are our favorites.
Our first child, Cassie, is very self-motivated, driven. Never have to worry about her. She's always on top of everything. Our second one, Charisse, is kind of like her father. Life of the party, thinks life's just a big party. Don't want to worry about too many things ahead of time. Jake.
You know, Jake is a personality of his own. He's kind of a combination of Cassie and Charisse.
Cassie is like me, is she's very methodical. Sometimes things have to be just a certain way, not always.
I think Cassie, one trait about Cassie I like, she does like to have fun, and I notice that when she's around her friends and her peers of some sort, they're always having a good time. As Cassie, Charisse, and Jake grow, is that they are starting to think on their own. Maybe you realize that some of the things we did teach them weren't so bad.
I'd say one of the greatest responsibilities as a parent is to just guide your children the right way and help them make the right choices.
Most things I enjoy about being a parent is just being part of the happiness the kids have when I see, especially during the holidays. I think the least is when you try to tell them something that you know it's a certain way, but they don't want to listen. But you know, later in life, they'll understand.
The one thing I would have done differently as a parent is I think to sometimes think things through instead of react right away. Sometimes in the heat of the moment, you say or do things that you regret later. And if you just take a step back and rethink things through, things go much better.
I would have spent my first child, Cassie, I would have spent more time with her because I was selling cars and I was gone a lot. Things I've changed, I've become a lot more tolerant, a lot more patient, kind of let things go as they go, because you can worry yourself to death. You really can.
You definitely have to be a lot more flexible when you have three kids and they're all about 2 years apart, each one of them.
Well, I think parenting has changed our relationship. You know, it adds a little bit more stress. We don't spend as much time, the two of us, but that's, we understand with having children, that's part of raising kids.
I think I have told you, I can't think of anything, but I will tell you again, I think you're a very beautiful young lady and very, very proud of you and what you have achieved. And I think it's great. What you're doing up here at Morningside and all the people you've met and all the great friends.
I smoked pot a lot when I was younger.
I smoked pot a lot when I was younger.
I smoked pot a lot when I was younger.
I've always wanted to tell you that.
It would be harder to raise kids starting right now than when we started back in 1992. Basically, yes, because of all the technology, the cell phones. At least we didn't have to worry about cell phone stuff with our kids till they were basically in junior high or middle school age.
work, the value of family, the value of always to never quit, always keep on, keep on. You know, whenever you have something you want to go for, just do it, get it done.
Always be there for your children and bring them up in a Christian home.
One of the things I regret that I didn't ask my dad is why he did not encourage me to be in the military. I wish I would have asked and pushed more to be in the military.
I regret not asking my parents enough about their past, about my dad when he was in World War II. Accomplishments that I am most proud of are my children. I feel like I have three beautiful children, and I'm proud of each and every one of them.
How we've grown together as a family.
I would like people to most remember me by that I was a caring person and very thoughtful and someone that you could always count on and rely on.
You know, I hope people remember me as a caring person, always wanted to help, always had a smile for everybody, was an encourager.
Hey, goodbye. Have a nice day. Thanks for coming in.
Okay. I'm just trying to... Thank you for Cassie interviewing us. I think this was an interesting experience.
Oh, okay. Anything else?
Is there anything else we likes to do? Can I have a joint now?
Oh my gosh, stop it.
Just kidding.
Okay. Oh. Yuck.
Are we going to the motel now?
A nice kiss. How did I do that?
You want us to film a movie or something?
Now what?
I don't know.
We wave goodbye?
Sure.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Have a nice day. Thanks for coming in.